Hello everyone, today I'd like to show you how you can change the visuals of your Hammer editor by using a program of mine called HammerThemes. This can be used to change most of the colors in the 2D viewports, so let's check it out. In the description of this video you'll be seeing a download link to the program itself. It looks something like this, the page. If you scroll down a bit, you'll see a link to the downloads page. On there, the versions are sorted chronologically, so the topmost is the latest one. You can simply click here to download the zip file to it. After downloading it, you can simply extract the entire contents of the zip to a folder of your likings. You can't run it from the zip directly, it'll not work this way. So now, with the zip unzipped, you can open the HammerThemes.exe file, and you'll be seeing a dialog something like this. By default, you only have one theme, which is the default theme. On the left-hand side, you'll be editing the theme, and on the right-hand side, you'll be seeing how the theme looks like with a simple preview window, something like this. You can start by creating a new theme, and here you'll be seeing the list of properties that you can be changing. So we can, for example, go and edit the background color to be like a light blue and see the changes update immediately. You can do this for all kinds of colors. By selecting them, you can see down here what the color exactly means and how it'll be showing in Hammer. So we can just go and, for example, say that selections shouldn't be red anymore but blue, and when dragging a brush it should go green instead of yellow. And you'll see this also immediately showing in the preview. You can also change the grid size or how bright the grid should be over here, as well as, of course, toggling it to the dotted grid mode. You'll be seeing this column here called intensity. This only really changes if you have your grid intensity set to something, because in Hammer Editor settings you have a slider to change how bright the grid should be, and you can change which of the grid colors should be influenced by that. So for example, if you disable the intensity checkbox for the regular grid, you'll be seeing the slider doesn't change for the main grid lines anymore, but only for those that are highlighted. It's recommended to keep all of these off, actually, and instead tinker with the values yourself here, because the intensity slider is kind of hard to keep track of and to see what the color will look like in the end. When you're done, you can just go down here on Apply Theme, and you'll see that the current theme will have changed to the one you've created. You can also export theme files to a file called HET files, which you can then later re-import. This allows for sharing your custom themes, like this one I've created for myself, with your friends or communities. Alright, so once we apply the theme, we have to go and restart Hammer because the changes aren't immediately visible. So after reloading the map, you can see that while the 3D viewport hasn't really changed much at all, the 2D viewport looks basically the same as in our preview. Something that you might need to take a look at is in the 2D viewport settings, there is the checkbox for the white on black color scheme. You should always have that on, because if it's off, you might be seeing that some colors, like the grid color, is not going to be working correctly. You can also not change certain colors of the 2D viewports, and of course most of the ones in the 3D viewport are also locked. So yeah, that's basically it. That's the entire program and how you use it, and how you can use it to change your Hammer editor's looks. If you have any more questions, be sure to ask in the comments. Other than that, I'd appreciate your support, and see you another time.